Welcome back from the break. We're still here with Darren. Darren, they say you have a blog online that you use to write your experiences, yeah?
Yes.
How is it so? How is it going?
It's going well. It started in February of this year. But it took a year for me to actually start. I had been thinking about it since 2022. Why? Because so many people had been asking me, Darren, how did you do this? Why did you start this? How have you been able to continue running the things that you run? And I said, you know, why don't I just create a space or a hub that houses all this information? So that if anyone has anything that they want to learn from the experiences that I've done or from the work that I've done already, there is a go-to place. And so the blog serves as that, but it also serves as a medium to house the work that the foundation does. So when I do foundation work, I write about the experience from the foundation work. Then when I do my podcast with all these guests, I still write about the lessons learned. So it's, they're all feeding each other. And it's an alignment that that I learned from one of my Canadian mentors, Mr. Michael Prosserman. And he taught me about really aligning the work that you do so that everything feeds into each other.
Oh, like there's a synergy.
There's a synergy, exactly.
Okay. Now, have people who visit your blogs, do you have any measure of what the blog means to them? What's their takeaway?
Yes, I actually do. Recently, I attended a graduation of my brother at Aga Khan as well. And I met so many young people that were in his age group, and they were telling me, you know, Darren, the stories that you write about your experiences in Canada really helped. We are learning about what to expect when we go to Canada, what we should prepare for when we're going to Canada. And just listening to them sharing their thoughts, like, oh, what you said about this really helped me. Now I'm doing this and this.
You're an influencer.
No. I don't want to say an influencer. I'd prefer the word someone that's trying to, you know, inform and inspire, which essentially is the mission of the blog.
So now that you live in Canada, yeah, in what ways have you immersed yourself in Canadian society and then engaged with the locals?
That's a good question. And one of the ways that I've really tried to is, first of all, learn their culture, learn what they value in terms of their work ethic, the things that they take seriously.
Give us an example, please.
Of the things that they take seriously. In terms of their work ethic, they're very diligent and they are very focused on exactly what they set out to do. Yes, there's fun, just as in any other place, but the level of expertise that they show and professionalism when they're doing their work is something that I admire, because as someone who also wants to get to that level of professionalism in everything that I do, there's a lot that I've picked from that. So I wouldn't say that they have extremes of one is party life fully and then one is work fully. I think they find ways of working with the two to ensure that one is augmenting the other.
When you speak of professionalism, give us an example. What do you mean by professionalism?
I mean in the way that they approach that the work they do. So for example, I'll take you back to when I was working at Waterloo International. The due diligence that they get. So because it's a huge university, it's one of the best in Canada, top five. So they get so many partnerships internationally to want to work with them, do exchange student programs. And seeing how the request to partner comes in, then it goes through step one, they evaluate. Step two, they do due diligence to see if it aligns with where exactly the university intends to go. And then it goes to the next level, which it is evaluated by the top bosses and then met. So seeing how they follow processes and sticking to the processes,
oh, yes,
regardless of
of
who's coming to ask, was something that I was...
You don't even have to be someone's father's friend.
That's,
you know,
impossible.
Even it's a system.
It's a proper system. Whether you are the biggest university in the UK that wants to partner with the University of Waterloo, there's a system that has to go.
Okay. So for you, that's your takeaway.
That's one of the takeaways. But then the other takeaway is the fact that it's so culturally different in terms of you know, here in Uganda, what I appreciate and love for our country is that we are free people, you know, and we are happy in whatever circumstance that we're in. We find joy in the little things. But because Canada, it's sort of, the system is running every day. It's hard to sit back and appreciate the little things and be like, wow, this has actually happened to me. Or wow, why don't I enjoy this? Because you never know what to expect. One day it could be snowing, the other day it's sunny. So you're always on your feet in Canada. And it takes a lot to slow down and be like, okay, this is happening. Let me take in this moment for a minute. Let me breathe. Because there's always something happening.
Now, you've talked about the professional part, but you're a student and you have a social life. So how has that immersion worked out for you?
Socially, it has been really good. Why? Because Canada as a whole, it's hard to pinpoint who exactly is a Canadian. Because there's so many people coming in from different parts of the world. You have Asia, you have Africa, you have the Caribbean, South America, Europe. And so you have native as well. So you have so many different people coming in, bringing in different thoughts of school of thoughts, opinions, perspectives. Mm-hmm. And because of that, it becomes easy to work with people. And because you're learning, everyone's learning from each other. Yes, there'll be moments where you're like, oh, the way you're viewing this isn't the way I'm viewing this. But because you're all learning, so there's so many cultural experiences that you go through, whether it is visiting the Asian Student Society and learning about them, then the African Student Society. And then because for me, I'm a huge fan of football. Yeah, they call it soccer. Every weekend, I'm always playing with my friends at the university or in competitions and tournaments that we've...
So besides football, what else do you do for fun?
For fun, sometimes I do go out with friends in the different areas, but it's mostly interacting with people. I love interacting, talking.
Dancing?
No, not really. I know how to, but I don't do it actively.
So when do you dance?
It depends on the kind of music that's being played, but because the African culture and our music is much better, that's usually where the alignment to the dance is. But like I said, the most that I do is, you know, mostly in sports, then interacting with different people, speaking to different people in different capacities. That for me is what gets me going. And
that's what makes you tick.
That's what makes me tick, yeah. I like learning from different things that I do and from different people in different walks of life.
So how has living in Canada broadened your perspective on global issues?
Quite massively, actually. Because because the things that I thought that I knew, I went there and I was like, wow, this is how the world, the Western world, does the work. And that stems from the way that they do their professionalism, from how just things as simple as when you go to buy something, they have their own tax-based systems, they have their own different, you know, markets and all that they go, that you go to buy things. But what from a global perspective, what it's done is it has allowed me to appreciate that we're different in terms of where you come from, but it also has shown me that in our differences, there's still the opportunity to collaborate and to work with each other. And it's shown me that above and beyond the horizon of of Uganda, there's so much information that exists out there, and it only comes from going out and talking to people, you know, experiencing life with people, whatever walk or path of life you're in, and not having this elitist mindset that, oh, because I'm like this, I can only hang with these kind of people, you know. Okay. And so from a global perspective, it is maybe appreciate the fact that we're different and that in our differences we can work together to essentially achieve a goal that we want, because at the end of the day, everyone's trying to make a difference in whatever capacity that they can.
So while that's Canada, Toronto, right?
The university's in Kitchener. Okay. Yeah, so that's Waterloo. Uh-huh. But Toronto is like the hub of...
The hub, eh? Okay. Now I just want to know, while you're in Toronto, what do you miss most about home?
The weather.
Really?
Yeah, but that's just... But
don't tell me the dust.
Oh, no, I don't miss the dust at all. But For me, it's being with people and just being myself and being free. So when I'm in these four walls of that we call home, it's a totally different Darren than what it is in Canada. The Darren in Canada is a bit more focused and know he understands that he's here to do A, B, C, D. Mm-hmm. He will have a bit of fun, but the level of fun exists more when I'm here. And I think I miss that comfort that comes with being at home. Because in Canada, you're always moving, you're always trying to look for a place to stay, look for this and that. And that culture of trying to move and change that Canada has is different from what it is here. And because of that fact, I really miss, you know, being home. Yeah, that's true.
Okay. So how important is networking and building relationships with mentors in the entrepreneurial world? And what advice would you give the young ones, young entrepreneurs? Because you did that, you said, when you first arrived in Canada.
I actually wrote a blog on how to build and maintain your professional network. And I interact with so many people about building your professional network. And what I can say is that it's very important to build your professional network, because there is a saying, your network is your net worth. But also, the people that you network with, mentors, they are the ones who will eventually take you to the next level that you want to get to. Mm-hmm. So when I went to Canada, I had a deliberate...
So you don't believe in these people who come out to tell us, I'm self-made?
I believe in self-made, but I think it gets to a point where you need someone to take you to the next level. You might need to meet someone, but the only way to get to that someone is through someone you already know. So I made a deliberate effort when I went to Canada. Every person that I meet, either through work or through school, I'll make an effort to connect through LinkedIn. And just after I connect through LinkedIn, I'll send a short message introducing myself. They call it cold introductions. Say who you are, what you do, what you intend to get out of this, and just appreciate the work that the person is doing so that they feel like you appreciate them, but also you really want to learn from them. And so, because I made a deliberate effort.
Baby steps of a relationship.
Yeah. You do your introduction, and then they'll begin, you pique their interest, because now they begin to follow and see the work that you do. And then, if you can, ask them to mentor you, because I don't think there's an individual that would not want to mentor someone. In whatever capacity, that's what I think. It might be as simple as sending them short messages or whatever, but just being there for someone is key. And so, that's what I made sure that I did when I reached Canada. So I have a plethora of different mentors from so many different aspects, whether it's in CEOs of different companies, or whether it is executive directors of nonprofits, or whether it is just professors.
My only concern is that we're often told that too many cooks spoil the broth. So if you
that's
have a plethora
true.
Of
that's
those,
also true. It's not. It's
don't they at one point, you know, have a collision, you know, in approach to
even when there's always a reason as to why I want to approach or meet someone. It's not that I'm just meeting them just because I can.